much for your company this Wednesday morning. Tim Bonython's love affair with shooting the world's biggest waves began the day he was given his first camera by legendary radio man John Laws. In the three decades since, the award-winning filmmaker has captured the majestic and power of the world's biggest waves. A big welcome, please, to Tim Bonython. Tim, thank you for joining us. I get scared on my boogie board in the waves. Tell us how you film the waves. You capture extraordinary images.
Well, I suppose it's like any sport. You know, if you're at the most extreme part of it, you know, if you're climbing mountains, you're probably going to climb Everest and get to the top and want to be documented. And for us, it's all about getting involved with dealing with the world's scariest moving walls of water.
It's the size of a five-storey building, for the love of God.
Coming at you.
That's in Tahiti. It's probably my favourite slab in the world called Chopua. It's a kid, it's 17 years of age, and he's one of the great new big wave surfers. There's a lot of new great
But where are you when you're taking that shot? Have you got a long lens?
Yeah, no, not really. See how you got the jet skis there? Well, I'm on a boat, and we're basically getting as close as we can, and obviously it's up to the driver to keep us in a safe place and obviously as dry as possible. But, you know...
Does he have a miscalculator? that is coming at you like the Great Wall of China.
It is, and, you know, I mean, this is on a boat. This wave's in Western Australia and, there has been the odd occasion where the boat's been in the wrong position and the boat's been hit.
What goes through your head then? Are you looking somewhere else then all of a sudden bang you're under?
Or I'm concentrating on the shot because it's my job to make sure that we're going to get that split-second moment. You know, that moment is critical for not just for me, but also the surfer. They're not doing it just for the fun. They're doing it because they really want to be seen and documented, and their sponsors, you know, pay them to be seen, you know, and there's a lot of different awards and all sorts of things for that split-second moment.
Have you ever come close? Have you ever thought, that's it, I'm gone? What's the closest you've
come
to?
Tahiti at Chopua, I got very, you know, a monster wave came through and we had a Tahitian driver driving through. He jammed it into drive so quick that I fell off the front of the boat into the inside the boat, and I'm looking up at him and he's like looking, eyes beating, and like I was like, oh no, we're going to get collected by a huge wall of water here. But he said to me, it wasn't the wave that was scaring; it was him driving over all the surfers in the lineup, trying to get out the back and avoiding this.
Do you wear a life jacket? Wow.
I always seem to have one, but I never seem to wear it. I always feel like it's all right.
And Tim, I mean, looking at those pictures, you capture remarkable images. Are there times when you're on the board, when you've been surfing in those big waves as well?
Well, as a filmmaker, I've decided that it's my job to get the moment. And, you know, there are these gentlemen are really, you know, they're athletes. They train for this moment. They know what to deal with in the most significant critical moment and how to maximise it. The best surfers make it look easy. Mm. You know, a Kelly Slater. These guys are big wave surfers and that's what they are. They're professional athletes and there is a big wave world tour. And, you know, these guys get paid to surf mountains. Mm. And, you know, they're a different genre than the world touring surfer, which is on the championship tour, you know, the top surfers like your Joel Parkinson's, Mick Fanning's, Kelly Slater's. So these guys are actually, there's a list of top big wave surfers and they get paid good money to ride monsters.
It's incredible.
Tim, super quickly, because we've run out of time, we could talk to you all morning. You're involved in a film festival. Tell us what people...
I run the Australian Surfing Movie Festival and it's kind of like the old Leyland Brothers, Albie Mangles, taking the movies on the road. I host every show. We have door prizes in between. And we go to a lot of cinemas now, but we do the odd show where I actually set up the projector and screen and, you know, we roll the jaffers down the aisle. Right. But it's a lot of fun and we're doing the whole East Coast tour at the moment and down at Wollongong and Ulladulla this next couple of days. Now we're going up to Newcastle and up to Noosa. So plenty of shows to look at.
Right.
We love your work and thanks so much for joining us. And details of when the Australian Surf Movie Festival is coming to your area, check all the details on the website surfingvisions.com.